Hello, my beautiful friends. I'm outside enjoying this beautiful day that God gave us. I hope you get a chance to get outside too. Look, do you all see this? This is some onion grass. Do you have some onion grass in your yard too? You know, I was watching my husband pull it up. I'm not pulling it up, but I was watching him pull it up, and it made me think all winter. The only thing for this onion grass is this bulb underground. There's nothing up in our yard. And you know the preacher's so happy about that. Let me show you another. Ask your mom and dad or your family before you do this. Don't go digging in your yard and telling them Miss Suzanne told you you can dig these up. Let me show you right here. My mom and I planted these. And every single winter, we planted them probably 10 years ago. Every winter, they go away. And I think, what happened to my beautiful blue flower? Look at that. I just love that color. If I've got a box of crayons that has that color, that is my go-to. I'm loving that color. But all winter, all I see is the ground. I don't see any beautiful plant. Then when spring comes, the plant comes up again. And let me show you. Here's another one right there. Can you see it? That's still growing up. So those are beautiful. All winter, they're in the ground. Can't see them. I can't enjoy them. Then when spring comes, they come up again. Let me put that one. I'm going to plant it again when we're done. You know, that also reminds me of a time that Jesus was away from his friends. After Jesus was grown and not living with his parents anymore, there was a time when he went out into the desert. And he went out into the desert all alone. Nobody came with him. Not his bestie, not any of the disciples, not his mama, not his daddy. He was completely alone there in the desert. The Bible tells us that Jesus was bothered by different things. He was bothered by whether the whole world belonged to him. He was bothered by whether he had enough money. Jesus was bothered out there in the desert by himself. He couldn't talk to his friends. He was in a form of social isolation, wasn't he? It was just Jesus out there, just like it's just us today in our house. But you know, that time for Jesus didn't last forever. The Bible tells us that Jesus prayed to God. He said, "Dear God, don't leave me out here like this. I don't like being all alone. I don't like having all these bad thoughts in my head. I don't like worrying. I don't like thinking about tomorrow. I don't like wondering. And I especially don't like being apart. And I don't like being apart from God the Father." He was very alone there. And God the Father talked back to him. He said, "You know what, Jesus? You're not alone. I see that you're suffering. I see you're lonely, and I see you're worried. And I'm going to give you angels. And those angels will be with you all the time. My flower in the winter, I can't see it. In the spring, it comes back again." God did not leave Jesus in the desert for 40 days by himself. God was next to Jesus, and God's angels were next to Jesus. God will not leave us this COVID-19 time, this time when mama and daddy say, "Can't go to the park, can't go to the store, we're not gonna go to the movies." It is not gonna be like that forever. God will not leave us like this forever. God did not leave Jesus alone. He did not leave Jesus forever. And God will not leave us alone. And he will not leave us like this forever either. Just like my bulbs are in the ground all winter, then spring comes and they pop up. That's what it will be like for us too. When this is all over, we're going to have a marvelous party. We'll have an Easter when this is all over. When this is all over, and when our life is all over, we're going to have a magnificent party. A magnificent party in heaven with Jesus. Jesus was never left alone, and we will never be left alone. Now, I want you to do this for me. Part of what makes me still connected to other people, to my family, is I know that in the morning, every single morning, we all say the same prayer. Whether I'm here in North Carolina, or I'm in Wisconsin, or California, or Tennessee, Colorado, Florida, wherever my family is, even New York, wherever my family is, we can be connected. We can be connected every morning with the same prayer. So I've got that below here for you in the comments. Ask Mama and Daddy to look it up in the comments. And I would be love, love, love to be connected with you every morning as well. Until I can see you again face to face, until we can have that magnificent Easter party, I'm gonna ask God be with you, take care of you, and keep you safe. And I'm gonna see you on the flip side soon. Love ya. Now I gotta get up.